Okay guys, to continue for this video, I will show you a monitoring system for my prototype of a tissue culture laboratory. So, let's continue. Let's open the Visual Studio 2000 job because I create my project here. So, the appearance is like this. This is connect part. So let's start. Let's try to run this project. Okay. Wait a second. Okay. The project is running. So this is flash. Okay. Okay, this is home of my monitoring system. I can then connect port. So this drop down box is to find the microcontroller or port connect here. So if we put the port on our laptop or our PC, it will detect and just click connect. So if you click connect, because if you click connect, there's no error because there's no exist of port here. So I'm sorry, I cannot show you for today to connect here because the prototype is not here with me. So this button is to save the data here, the temperature and humidity, also date for today or when you gather data, and then you save data. Yeah, error because there's no data here. So this is humidity and then temperature here. So that's the button of connect part, and then this is the data inserted on our database. So this is a search box. This example, we will find the temperature 30 degrees maybe. Okay, we have 30 degrees on March 13, 2019. So that we have. So you can search and you can also print. Click print here, and here we go. You can choose the printer here, or we just try to save it on PDF. Okay, let's print on PDF. Give name for this one. Data for. Okay. Okay, data 4. So let's open this tab. Oh, anyway, let me save it. Wait. Here, data 4. Let's open it. Okay, so the data is like this. The same like this. Okay. So it's up. And then for chart, the chart is average of all temperature and humidity. So like here, so the calculation is the average of all the data inside our database here. Let's run. So every 2 seconds or 3 seconds I set this one, it will automatically generate the average. So it's like what you can see. So about the system is just like that. So okay, that's great. I will show you the code. Okay guys, so first to connect, okay, we go to connect port. First we have this one. Okay, this is a chart, just connect, and this is the drop down box. So let's see the all data here. So we input here. Okay, we have this one. So if you have the MySQL, this using MySQL data, you just click the click here to add reference. Add reference sample, add reference. Oh, add reference. Okay, just click that one to connect your system to your database, so MySQL. So let's see the code. So private daytime for today. Okay, static. This code is to connect your database, your system to your database. And then serial port. This is a serial port from your microcontroller. And then data port. So string data. So the data from the microcontroller will save here. So get the data here. Okay, so if you put the data, you put the port, the port will appear on the drop down box. So load. So this code for the port, for the port. Okay, so here to appear the and this one here, the code of this one is here to appear the data inside the text box here. So let's continue. Okay, to save data from text box here, on this button we have this code to save data here. So the file name This is one, this one. Okay, so we have the Drive C user documents resource development project is equal to this folder. We put the data here. So let's continue. Okay, this is the part. This part for this is actually the constant of the constant code for the port. You can see or you can find this code on other tutorial or maybe on Google. You can find it. So private button click here. Port is connect, so this is disconnect. For disconnect, disconnecting the port from your device. Okay, save data. So insert, just save data on your save data to table data. Okay, so here. Okay, this is for chart. Okay, so next we go to diagram. So for diagram, you can see what code we put here. Okay, the code is almost same. So we use the data grid view here. Okay. So this for timer. This timer is for the automation button click here. This is the code. Okay, so okay, so almost the same. And then we go to search here. So let's find it here. So about okay, the code here, as you can see, just like another form, but here we put here to search the data inside our database. So as you can see here, this data is select, yes, this one, to find the data from the database. Update, this is for data grid view. So bitmap is, this is for print. This is code for DGV printer. And select, yeah, like that. So just like that. So that's all, and thank you.